The sea, an environment full of life and at the same time very fragile, has to be protected and preserved every day, because everyday human pressures can challenge its delicate balance. ...90% of the global transport of goods is carried by sea. Around 50,000 merchant ships sail the oceans of the world, corresponding to a total dead weight of about 600 million tons. When the ship is traveling without cargo, or with only a partial load, it must acquire additional weight on board to maintain stability and operate safely. This additional material is called ballast. The vessels charge and discharge ballast water to improve the trim during the operations of loading or unloading of goods. The waters are generally taken inshore or in port and, once the ship arrives at its destination, are discharged. In ballast waters, there are both sediments and organisms, bacteria, algae, small invertebrates, eggs, and larvae, which can then be introduced into a new environment, the receptor port or neighboring waters. It is estimated that, globally, ships transfer 3 to 5 billion tons of ballast water per year. In the ballast tanks of ships around the world, there can be up to 7,000 different aquatic species. The introduction of organisms to new environments through ballast water of ships is a major threat to the health of the oceans. The possible consequences are environmental, economic, and health-related. Introduced species can compete with negative species for food and space, can feed on native species, alter habitats, alter hydrographic conditions and the food web, even replace native species. They can thus reduce biodiversity. Possible economic impacts are related to the proliferation of encrusting species, biofouling, on the hulls or on coastal infrastructure. Also, aquaculture, fisheries, and tourism can be negatively impacted. For example, the comb jelly Nemiopsis leidyi, a native species of the Atlantic Ocean, was introduced in the early 80s in the Black Sea through ballast water, and in less than 10 years has caused the collapse of the anchovy fishing industry. Nemiopsis is a voracious predator of fish eggs and larvae. Impacts on human health can also occur, caused by the proliferation of toxic algal species or venomous species and by the presence of pathogens. There is evidence that the epidemics of cholera along the Peruvian coast in the early 90s are to be associated with discharges of ballast water. With the expansion of the world trade and an increasing number of ships moving between international ports, the transfer of pathogenic microorganisms could represent a particularly insidious threat. There is one main international response to prevent, minimize, and ultimately eliminate the risks to the environment, human health, property and resources arising from the transfer of harmful aquatic organisms and pathogens through ballast waters. It is the International Convention for the Control and Management of Ballast Water and Sediments of Ships. The Ballast Water Convention was signed in London in 2004 at the IMO, the International Maritime Organization of the United Nations. The convention is now nearing entry into force.
The Maritime Organization started with this issue in early 1990s, prepared in 1990 some guidelines, and actually in 2004 International Convention for Ballast Water Management and Management of Sediments was adopted in London. This is now the main international instrument, which however at this point didn't yet enter into force, but is very close, and we actually hope that we'll enter in 2016 or at latest 2017.